Lumberjack season. Tonight, if you've never seen long form comedy, it's basically a made up 20 minute play based on your suggestion. I got more to say, that's why I'm skipping the explanation. We have a super special show tonight. We have like 1,000 people from NYU here also performing. They are also going to be doing improv comedy, so because it's going to be a bumpy ride. I'm just going to go ahead and get the show started. We have our first team up, off-center, starting off strong. We have the Pumpkin Spice Girls. Can I get them?
Mel B. We are going to get going. We're going to put on a completely improvised set for you right now. We need some ideas from you, the audience, so we can put this on. So raise your hand, both people. I just want to hear, what are you dressing up as for Halloween?
A slut.
A slut?
Yeah!
Oh, that's right, Halloween elf.
Crippling depression.
Crippling depression! My everyday clothes. Let me get one more. We got one, yo.
Ronald McDonald.
Ooh, that's a good one. So we got Qui-Gon Jinn from episode one, Ronald McDonald, a slut, and crippling depression. We're going to Ronald check you right now. Halloween! So. We got all the movies we can play. I'm really thinking Inside Out, like about emotions and stuff, and like if they were real and stuff, right?
Yeah.
So, but I feel like they really simplified it, because they only have the 5 emotions. Yeah. And I really think they're lacking the crippling depression aspect of a lot of teenage girls.
I think that would be a great addition, yeah.
So, I don't really think that would be great for like, you know, a hangout movie night.
Yeah, but you know, it's just not realistic.
Yeah. Now, Lion King, that's a good one.
Oh, yeah.
I love the idea that, like, one line with, like, Scar, that's then named Scar before he got Scar. After getting Scar.
Yeah,
like, it's like you knew what was gonna happen. Like, you knew, like, everything's planned out.
Yeah, so. You always know what's going to happen because it's going to be the worst thing that can possibly happen.
Yeah, everything just leads to its most logical conclusion. Which is why, again, like, they've got joy and not Inside Out. It's like, that's pretty cool, but like, they don't have ecstasy. In a me of joy. It's kind of sad, man.
Hey, you guys run movies too?
Yeah.
Star Wars Episode 1. Doesn't seem to be much ecstasy. I don't know. Yeah, that's what I want.
Yeah, it's more like pure joy and happiness all the time.
Yeah, that's... Oh, let's see, they got cars. That's weird. There's no dinosaurs in this. What the fuck?
Yeah, they're not accurate.
Oh, these are awful.
The disc isn't even a car.
What?
It's a disc. It's, but it's called Cars.
It's supposed to be. A disc. You can't play a car.
But then why would they call movie discs?
Because then every movie would be called discs.
It doesn't make sense though.
Movies it's what it's about the contents of the disc.
It doesn't fit the theme though. It's the theming.
Hey Tom. You playing dress up as the Burger King tonight?
Yeah. And you're gonna be.
Yep, I'm just slutting myself up for Ronald McDonald.
I'm gonna be your king.
Oh, yeah. I don't know, this fast food fetish porno shoots are really weird. Alright.
guys, do I have to be slutty French fries?
Yeah. Why can't I eat French fries?
Why can't I be something body positive, maybe a little lighter?
Tell you what, there's a Grimace costume in the back. The only thing that's slutty is it's just the Grimace costume, but Grimace is wearing lingerie. I'd be like, still, not my costume. But you know what? If it's what the director wants, it's what the director wants.
No, I think it's going to take us to be fries.
Okay. So we're going to be slutty fast food characters. Why? This is fucking stupid, isn't it?
People demand it.
All right. So, yeah.
We got to do what he says.
After this, I do have another shoot miles away. Dressing up like an attorney, just in full-on business attire. And, fucking it's weird. A full suit, that's what people want. Let me start getting, you know what, I'm gonna just put the business suit on over my Ronald McDonald.
Hey, strip down the back. Can you check out my slutty dance and see if it's good enough?
Oh, the director's here. Oh god.
Ronald, you're gonna have to take the pants off. Like we already shot the first scene, so
Look at my chicken McNuggets. I'm loving it.
Cars 2!
No, Cars 1!
No!
What about Blaze?
Blaze! Nobody talks about Blaze anymore! Blaze Fire Rescue saved that series!
Saved the series!
Listen, Inside Out captured the human emotions perfectly!
No, it was completely off!
No! Toy Story! I'll say it once, I'll say it a thousand times more important than any other!
Toy Story 3 is far better than any other Toy Story!
I'm willing to settle on 2, but I won't go any lower! Wolf getting Bugs Life? Nobody else thinking Bugs Life right now! Liam Neeson wasn't even in Bugs Life!
So, like, why do they call it a daisy? It doesn't...
I don't know. I mean, we could try and look up the etymology, but it's not important.
But it doesn't look like a person. Like some chips?
No, it's the other way around. People are named after flowers.
I've met plenty of daisies that don't look like flowers. I've only met daisies that don't look like flowers.
There's other flower names too, like rose.
That one, yeah, thank you. Right?
I don't think you're seeing what I'm saying. Like, people don't necessarily look like what they're named after, you know? Like, people with the last name Green aren't green, right?
Are you? Yeah, and it's pissing me off, right? Like Venus, that's such a dumb name.
Hey guys,
but like non-planet.
John Shippenpants, how's it going? Oh, totally clean. Not actually Shippenpants.
No, same. When are you going to?
Your name is John Shippenpants.
Son of Mary and John Shippenpants.
Where did you get that name?
Grandson of Lord.
Okay, I want to speak with your father.
All right. Dad.
You're telling me this is a real name, but tell him the name you said.
No need to look. No,
it's no. There.
Why are you not living up to your expectations?
I'm sorry.
I want to shake your hand. Thank you.
No. You want to talk to our good buddy Patrick Shakes Hands?
Yes. Yes.
I thought it wasn't blood.
This is fucking ridiculous.
What are you talking about?
You're ruining what names are supposed to be. You're giving this guy false expectations.
They're exceeding my expectations. Look at him. He looks like he's going right now.
People don't do what they're named after in the real world.
Let me go get my friend White Guy.
See?
White guy.
You see, you're missing out on all of this. Because you're called Vision. And you got those.
Yeah.
I want to apologize for the fact that everything's not making sense to you. But why is it called Daisy?
I don't know. I don't know anymore.
Hey,
John Mervia?
Pleasure to meet you.
Steamboat Willie.
Go pursuit for sexy Sully.
Okay, let me just practice my laugh.
Guys, do I happen to be the only Disney princess in the show?
Yeah, everyone's always like, hold on, let me take the Mickey ears off. Let me get on the big old Goofy shoes. Let me practice our speed.
Yeah, so I was watching your movie.
doesn't make any sense. I can't work with this.
What does it matter?
I can't get off unless I have a good plot.
It's just sex!
You don't have to get any money if you don't have a good plot, right? I'm just telling you how it is.
Mr. Okay. I had my own change of heart.
Oh.
I would like... We gotta switch it up then.
Okay.
So... I know nothing about Disney lore.
Actually, us actors who wrote the script.
Does it make sense? Then that's all that matters. Wonderful. How much sex is there?
Well, let's just say Mickey and Minnie are expecting a third little mouse in the air.
You expect to find one fully clothed?
Listen, I was 8 years old. I know we're in our 40s, Jim, but I saw it all those years ago.
You didn't even pick it!
No, it was like in my backyard somewhere. The house has since been sold. I'm sorry. We gotta break it.
Goddamn fortress!
Let's go. Oh yeah, it's a fortress now. I forgot to mention that. They stored gold in there. Alright. You know what?
You know this is stupid.
It's very stupid. Tell you what, forget the clover. There's kind of a bigger problem I have.
Bigger than the poorly clover? Leave your other friend because he couldn't help you find a dead AA battery? Surprise, it's been dead!
Here's the thing. I lost my son a couple months ago. And I was like, I can look for the son, but I think if I find the poorly clover, I'll get lucky. Find my son. Let's get the clover!
Lake house, just sitting with my new adopted son, because he was just out on the street, nobody wanted him.
Excuse me, are you, I would imagine my parents know you're Mr. Johnson, you bought the house from my family?
Yeah, that's not correct.
You look...
That's Michael!
You know, he looks like... I can't put my finger.
Your last name?
Thompson.
Michael Thompson!
Well, my son's name was Michael Thompson! Yeah, small world!
Wait a minute!
Hey, honey, I
went outside and
it was fully
closed. Oh, well, I added to the collection!
Cool!
Slutty lumberjack?
Yep, slutty daft.
Slutty burger.
Slutty ghost.
Slut.
Slutty slut.
Slutty slut.
Slutty slut. I'm going
to be slutty preschool teacher. Slutty axe murderer.
Slutty skeleton.
Slutty angsty teenager?
Ooh!
Yeah.
Slutty corpse!
Jacob Alexandre, thank you so much!
NYU. It's Home and Profit. Come on up here. Except one year, when I was like 7 or 8, some people came to the pumpkin festival after everybody left and like smashed all the pumpkins. And like the shockwave that rippled through my town. Amazing. Like literally, it was the next day. I was like, "Yeah, did you hear about the pumpkins?" Like, "Yeah, no, it's insane." I was at home. You know, Sharon called me, and yeah, we just went and kind of sat there for a while, lit a few candles. Yeah. it was very interesting.
Back to school. the Dr. Oz show. Today our guest is Mr. Ricky Bobby, and back at the 15-year anniversary of the terror that shocked this town. Mr. Bobby, you know, looking back to almost two decades later, how do you feel about this?
Well, I was just 6 years old.
You know, they say that's the most at-risk age for pumpkin smashing.
It's okay. I mean, I've had a lot of time to settle with it. You know, I've recreated a lot of pumpkins, you know, every year, the same one. It's a little dated now. I mean, my pumpkin was a caricature of Jerry Seinfeld. every year I harvest my own face, and every year it resonates with me, just a little less.
You know,
hey, shake and bake.
Yeah, I'm sorry. We just have some protesters in the audience. You know, they're still trying to find the PPP, the pumpkin protection people. They're a real danger to a certain part of our society, so we're gonna. But anyway, you know, I don't want to make you relive anything uncomfortable, but we just wanted to roll the tape from.
That sounds like a third.
You know, but that's what we thrive on here for ratings. It's, the television industry has become quite a heartless environment, you know, and no one really cares about Oprah Winfrey, you know, now in 2024. Jerry, you want to roll the clip?
Hey, let's smash this stupid pumpkin.
Yeah.
Wait, can we pause the clip for a second? You guys know who did it? White House is filled with rotting Jerry Seinfeld.
I understand your concern, and you know, we just wanted to make sure that all the records were clean. We didn't want to release the footage before, and you know, you seem busy, you know, parking your carpet. Parking your pumpkin.
The support group for this very event.
Exactly.
Takes up a lot of my time.
Exactly. You know, I hear you dropped out of college to come here. But let's
okay,
roll.
Okay, fine,
roll.
Yeah.
Let's pause it for a second. If you have kids at home, this is real sensitive material. Anyone in your life under 30, please cover their eyes. It's going to be quite traumatic from now on, so this is an advisory. All right, go.
Wow, that was such a rush.
That was, you know what, we should
smash every single pumpkin.
Wait, what if we take one and then just like make it pie? Like, why waste the pumpkins when we eat the pumpkins?
I like where you're going with this, but it's just, I don't know, it's just not holding back.
Sorry, can you pause the video again?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm not only offended that you had video of this, but you didn't even edit out like the talking part.
You know, times are tough. Everyone is quick. We just have one intern that, you know, makes the video, numbering, edits the video, you know, finds people to interview. I'm really sorry. He used to be a comedian, Jerry Seinfeld.
Oh, God, terrible.
Yeah, he had to resort to working.
I just personally, I feel like this whole event was just stacked against me, okay? You don't need to have an opinion on this. I'm just voicing my concern.
I hear that. I just felt like I should say something, you know, just fill the silence. But
I'm gonna go back to my dressing room and just kind of cry for a little bit. If that's okay.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
I'll just
cool.
Bam, you know, with the live audience. All right. Guys, do you want to see more of the video? I know it's really dramatic. Alright, you asked for it. Please play.
You know, before we smash the rest of these pumpkins, I just want to talk about how much I hate my ex-boyfriend.
Billy can literally, like, go cry in a dressing room for hours. Like, I don't even care.
You see pumpkin right here?
Yeah.
Doesn't it kind of look like him? It kind of looks like him.
Yeah, but you have to angle it, but yes, no,
definitely. I'm sorry, there's still a video feed going on in my dressing room.
There's no way to stop it, it's just...
No, it wasn't on before.
tips that we tell our guests, maybe hide under the table, cover your ears, cover your eyes. I don't really know what else to tell you.
Okay, yeah. I mean, I'll figure it out, I guess.
If you have a blindfold, like, if that would help, I don't know.
Just turn it off. If you're going to provide the blindfold, just turn it off.
I'm going
back in the room. I'm sorry. Okay.
All right, play.
Take this, Billy.
Ah!
That felt so good.
So, I know that like a lot of these issues come from just how tiny you are, but like, you don't need to take it out on the pumpkins.
I'm not taking it out on the pumpkins. I'm... Okay. I guess I'm taking it out of the pumpkins, but it's only because I've always been an insurance my entire life. I just... Before I tell you about that, don't... Do you think this don't inch? Martha?
Welcome to our slam poetry night. the media. Is Roger here? Is that Roger?
Yes, it's me.
Okay, this name is yours.
Hey, everybody, this is my working physical art piece. It's called The Media. Heard of it? TV. TM. Z. Me? Slam. Poetry?
Poetry. In a tree, looking down. I look up, and yet I frown. I can't believe what's in my mind. It's going on just all the time. Appreciate all this love. Feel it raining from above. Fits me tight.
Like a glove. Love is to me as hate is to my enemies. I love to love. They hate. To love to hate. Not so great.
Drunk circle. I'm surrounded. I can't believe just stay grounded. I hope it doesn't last so long. I've got things later in the day. I won't have to cancel. That's not okay. Still going on with my swan song. Yet I feel like life just a big old gong. Dong, dong, dong.
Just like 2 weeks ago, what happened?
I got drunk.
Did you erase the whiteboard?
Yes, okay, I'm sorry.
Why are you being held to our no?
It was fun. And I just was like, you know what would be a fun thing to do right now? With my fireball, just like climb into the bell tower and then erase the whiteboard.
Okay, well, if you're not going to do it, I'm just going to ring the bell.
Go ring the bell.
Yeah, I'm missing 420.
I want us to figure out why we're both hesitant to ring the bell, okay? This is indicative of a bigger problem, I feel.
Listen, Jerry, I don't need this in my life right now, okay? We have a system in place. I messed up, okay? I'm sorry.
Well, I'm just going to kick the bell, okay?
Don't kick the bell.
There's an intent. Maybe you should kick 5 times and people will get the point.
Honey, is it American Idol time?
I don't know. I don't know.
I hear the people on the stage complaining.
They need to watch their American titles. Otherwise, who will they idolize America?
I don't know. Miss. Not us, surely. We can't figure out a simple bell system.
God damn it, Jerry!
If I miss Kelly Clarkson singing her song on the final night of American Idol, I'm
going to
go crazy.
You're
trying
to make people
let Tom in. I am trying. My best. I offered to work on American Idol Night, okay? I think it's a pretty neat offer for me.
I also offered to work on American Idol Night, okay? So there's no reason that both of us need, and the entire town needs to be missing American Idol.
Ring the damn bell!
Okay.
Ring the damn bell!
I think they can also turn on their TV,
yeah,
right?
So.
Yeah, I'm just gonna do it and then we can just hit it. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, great, nothing happened. I guess it's kind of pointless.
It's kind of pointless. It didn't really work.
Yeah. Well, okay, we tried.
It was a valiant effort.
Somebody had fireball left? That's all the
fireball. Holy fuck.
What is the song that you will be singing and also your name?
I'm going to be singing Runaway Bride by Kelly Clarkson.
I'm sorry I am late. I will just sit behind you.
This man watches me watch you sing.
This is really just, I am so thankful.
I'm sorry. What is the name of the person who you will be hearing tonight?
What?
Clark Johnson.
He told me that his name is Clark Johnson.
Wonderful. Side by side. You look lovely.
Really, too. Quite ravishing.
Thank you. When do I get to sing?
Count down from 20.
20? I'm sorry, I can't help but notice on the back of your headshot there's a resume. It says you speak Hebrew.
Yes.
Do you mind doing the countdown in Hebrew?
$100 bill, it's kind of weird.
Yeah. We live together.
Yeah.
Action from you guys, and we're going to do a physical action that represents that, like painting a picture. And we're going to pass it back and forth, but each time we do it, we're going to have to justify it differently. So for example, if I'm saying I'm painting a picture, I can look at her and say, try that on for size. She takes the same action.
I'm engraving your tombstone.
Yeah!
It's a little lighter than that.
We'll see how it goes.
It's natural.
So, can we get an action?
Type in an
action. I'm coming into archery.
Putting icing on a cake.
Every day.
Every day.
Okay.
Sure. I'm putting icing on a cake. Try that on for size.
I'm rubbing a wide dish.
Try that on for size.
I'm buffing my car. Try that on for size.
I'm giving a kindergartner a hard nook.
I'm rubbing a person's bald head. Try that on for size.
I'm rubbing the head of someone with hair.
I'm rubbing an elbow. Try that on for size. Can we get another suggestion?
Somewhere.
I'm teaching a classroom how to make the peace sign.
All right. Yeah. Margaret! Every time I find you in the kitchen, you're with the Honey Nut Cheerios. 2 a.m., 4 a.m., 6 a.m. I set alarms.
Doctor said I need to lower my cholesterol. You should know that, Gabe.
There are more efficient ways to lower your cholesterol than eating Honey Nut Cheerios every 2 hours. I'm not a doctor. Go to the doctor if you want to lower your cholesterol.
I did, and he told me to eat Cheerios. Sorry, you're not understanding. You not care about my health.
Just listen. We had this conversation last week about how when I buy things from the grocery store, I want to be able to wake up the next morning and be able to eat the things I purchased. And I feel like these...
You say that I'm the only person eating Cheerios in this household.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
You care more about the little bee on the free cereal than you do about me.
You always do this, okay? You always make it about you, Margaret.
It's about me. It's about my doctor saying it is.
Yeah, so it looks like you have a bit of a high cholesterol problem. the only thing there's a free sample of some Cheerios.
Listen, I'm not gonna lie, business has been going really well since Kellogg sponsored this hospital. There's something unethical here. Like, people come in here with not just cholesterol problems, but like someone broke their foot and I told them,
yeah, you just charmed. It's creative. You have to find more creative ways to fix that. Cast the lucky charms.
Guys, sorry.
Sure, just come in.
Yeah. It's just that I came in here like 3 weeks ago with, you know, stage 2 leukemia, and I was really a bunch of fruit by the foot.
Yeah, it's not a Kellogg's foot.
Here, just go into the cabinets. So this is Fruit Loops. I don't know how this is gonna help.
Is it the fruit that cures the kid?
So, what did the doctor say?
Well. It's not really what he said, as much as what he told me to consume.
Are you gonna have to go to
the No, nothing like that. Yeah. Well, okay, so we're just gonna have to buy a lot more Fruit Loops.
I thought we had an abundance already, and we brought back so many packages from the hospital last time.
Okay, I'm quite sure I'm going to die. It seems like the health industry in this country has just gotten worse and worse. I don't know.
I can't help but feel partially responsible.
I'm glad that you said this disappointment. I understand that.
I'm not going to talk to you until my lawyer gets here.
That's fair. I am kind of.
I got here as soon as I
could. Thank you, God. You just got my text.
Yeah. Oh, you have a great lawyer. If only I had one of those.
You're going to need it.
No. We're not a profitable hospital. That's why we needed to get the Kellogg sponsored. We can't afford lawyers.
Is the class action suit going to go through?
We're trying. So.
Well, my son has a solution that's not a funny subject. they just came home with fruit. Stacks of fruit.
Really? Not Simon's just friends?
Okay, you know, I'll take that one. That one was on me.
What kind of establishment are you running?
Not a good one! I should. So here's the thing. The hospital has agreed to settle for $2 million. The only hitch is that it's $2 million in honey nut cheese.
Yeah.
They do know pigs fine.
No, no, I don't seem to know half that knowledge. What do we have? You better have troubles.
Guess it's just me again for dinner alone. Just flipping the truffles. I wouldn't think they came to be.
Oh, hey! I came back because I felt bad for you being alone.
Let me just.
Where's your family? Mr. O'Shaughnessy.
Yeah, I heard you. It's just it's a difficult question. So as you know, my family died in a horrific yachting accident. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna let you know. No, it was not my fault. No matter what anyone told me.
Don't do it!
There's toothpaste all over the floor. It's absolutely disgusting. I don't know how you brush your teeth.
Because I'm a knife thrower.
I just
thinking that I vomited at the sight of my own grandfather's body. Dead in the cast.
It's so funny though, because sometimes Bexy thinks she can also hit the high notes, but she can't. So I'm trying to hit these high notes, and Becky's also trying to hit them, and she's just not hitting them.
Oh, what do you mean you needed to cast it for that?
How did he do it again?
Hi, vicious. We
cut to his death. Accidents happen, man.
You get numb to this stuff after a while. I keep trying to watch all these messed up movies, these gory, like bloody, bad. Nothing hits me. Cry.
Really?
I haven't cried in so long.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Bring it on.
Yeah.
Bring it on.
I know what you're saying. This job is just changing me. I saw an old woman get hit by a truck the other day.
Nothing.
I didn't even go like help or like we should call someone.
Sorry, sir. we are out of chocolate ice cream. Sir, are you going to order something else?
Is there anything you can do about that?
No, I'm sorry, the chocolate ice cream is gone.
Excuse me, are you already gone?
Chocolate ice cream is gone. Are you going to cry? I'm sorry, can you please let him take his time? We've only got 3 flavors because we're organic.
So when's the rest of the movie? in life, I've killed more than one person. In my ass.
Careful there, honey. Right here we got a genuine gulch.
A genuine gulch?
Yeah, gulch. Okay, alright, just roll with me here. I want to take you around the Grand Canyon. I want to show you how much I know about nature and impress you a little bit, okay? So, let's move on.
As a geologist, I'd be like, this is the definition of mansplaining. Okay.
Whoa. I didn't mean to offend you.
No, tell me about the gulch. Especially
the gulch. It's a big hole and things can fall in it.
Oh,
no,
that's very nice,
no,
honey.
No, it's not a vagina thing.
Followed my vagina, okay? So calm down!
I didn't ask him.
Help us!
Oh, whoa! Alright, so right here, we got genuine.
We have bottles of Coke. That's Sprite for.
Two soda salesmen that have followed
me.
Very lyrical, please. And so, I know what we do in this situation. I researched before we went on this trip. We gotta get the rope that I brought for the trunk. I'm gonna go grab it and be right back.
Okay.
You want this rope for the trip? Take it straight.
You just see so fast. Take it straight, right? Yeah. Excuse me. Can I just? Yeah. Well. Oh, awesome.
Thanks. You guys seem like you're doing fine. You're gonna be in the rope.
No, please!
We haven't seen our families in years.
Have you guys just been surviving on Coca-Cola and Sprite?
Yeah!
That sounds super fun.
Sounds like I'll get the rope.
Hey, do you guys know about geology?
Dabble!
Not really a thing, though.
You dabble in it? I'm a geologist.
It's great! Can you guys set up the rope though?
Yeah, we can stay on the rope right here. I feel like it's weird. It's strange energy. I didn't mean to let you down by not saving someone.
No, you're amazing.
Really?
You're amazing. Love you.
Yeah.
Oh. Wait, can we get out of here?
No!
Here and
try to stop.
don't know. I'm secret.
Okay.
You don't even look 16. Anyways, my Uber is here.
Hey, Stacy, sit back down. You're gonna slip.
This will give me a pain.
No.
I hope you fucking slip, Stacy, witch bomb.
It's not true! 5'9! You better remember that!
5'8" and a half.
Alright, so a 6'7" guy comes up to your door in a dark alley. He says something. Is this a real story? Alright, sure, just keep going then. That's fine, that's what we're all about.
That's what it's all about. That's what it's
all about. So, every man's town, you know this guy's height just by looking at him. That's you're weird.
And he says, where are
your student loans?
Yeah.
He's been chasing you or your student loans? Wow, this guy's busy. Alright.
Where are your student loans go?
Yeah, where
I shat into my ankle. I just gotta drag him around this way.
You're only a freshman, so like you got a long way to go. Don't let it dark down. Just wait until you're a senior.
I've seen the storm on the horizon. It's gonna grow.
Okay, what?
Hey, is this
part of the story?
I think we left the story quite a long time.
Wait, so I asked for a story and you came up without a story?
Well, it all started in Long
Range. Oh, now, what did this guy do? When he asked for your student loans, did you tell him where they were? Or they were in the room because they were chatting with you?
Yeah.
So it's before the...
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Don't worry about any of that. Don't worry about it.
Very...
Where were they buried? I'm genuinely curious.
Wait, this is a real story. I actually want to know it.
Yeah, where were they buried?
Curious.
It's so funny. This sounds very dangerous and harrowing.
Very real.
No, you don't have to pretend to cry.
We
understand.
Yeah,
I wish I could
serve
them.
Yeah, right.
We
all
do.
That's why I'm
Yeah, the ceiling is like to come back to London.
Yeah.
You bury them in freshman year and now I'm back.
Very graduated.
They just come back on Halloween because they're zombies, you know? That's what they do. They just kind of pop out and just like,
That's a factual statement.
Yeah, it's right there.
I would use this in a court of law.
I don't think it's handed.
So he showed up, asked where they were. He didn't tell him, and just left.
Yeah.
He's not very good at his job. Yeah. Is he?
It's also a very simple story.
It was really
bad.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Break
it down. It just kind of just went nowhere.
What's this guy's name?
Philip.
So, as you can see,
teachers?
r/bigfoot. Everything on the internet has to be. So.
Yeah, yeah, but this picture is taken on a dark, stormy night, Long Branch, New Jersey. It's very, very believable.
There we go. Yep.
All right, let's get back to printing the truth. Things that actually happened. I got this story about this. There's apparently, like, 25 years ago, a meteor crashed in Kansas.
I heard about that.
Yeah,
hold up. 25
years. Yeah, a baby came out of it.
Guys, I got a story.
Oh my God.
Jim, you got a story!
I got a real story.
Give us a real story, Jim.
Yes.
Lay it on us.
Cheerios cure leukemia.
Stop the This is Superman. Cheerios.
Oh my God. This Long Branch paper is going to be famous. We can get Peabody Awards.
Hi,
I'm the guy giving out the Peabody Award.
Just on time.
Incredible.
Did you hear about the billionaire whose parents died in the alley?
Yeah.
That was us.
Really hard.
I got this bit.
Alright, sure.
Yeah.
If I can just go up and say hi.
I'm so sorry.
We're telling true stories. Come on.
Christ!
This is not a true story. Oh, you forgetting to bring out the chair.
Oh yeah, no, we're making it up for later.
Breaking news! News anchor fails to bring on a chair for our broadcast.
Tell us what's going on out there, Jeff.
Well, Jim, we have a very complicated situation when an intern failed to bring out a chair for a news anchor.
Is there anybody who can interview at the scene?
Yes. Let's get Jim out here. Hi, Jim. I know not to confuse you for Jim, the news anchor. Fun.
Yeah, we have an intern also named Jim. Yeah, just talk to him about what happened because obviously, God damn it, Mike.
There goes.
You forgot another chair.
Oh well, then. Could you please explain what you just saw?
Well, it looked like it was a man who was around 6'7", just following this kid around who had a bunch of paper shackled to his ankle, and he just kept harassing him, wanting his
That sounds like an interesting story. Back to you, Jim.
Fantastic. Well, here at Real News, we just try to give you the realest news. Oh,
so
you know what, Mike?
I'm so sorry.
We're gonna cut the commercial while I give Whitmig, and you know, when I get back, we're gonna tell the story from Blind Lawyer, who's a vigilante by night.
We've been doing this for like a year, and you still don't know how to talk to girls.
Dude, I don't know, man. I just choke up.
That's the most negative thing I've ever heard.
Oh, man. Dude, I don't know what to
do. Talk to that girl. She's clearly a girl by the way she's walking. I I messed up.
It's all my fault.
I told the story.
Why'd you lie? Why did you lie?
I thought it was a real story.
I thought it was all real, man.
I thought it was real.
Oh, come on.
They called me up. I didn't know what to say. I didn't know.
Anybody else got any other fake stories so I can get out of the way?
So there's this guy. He came to my house where I live alone, and then he was in the door. He was.
God damn! This is the same story. I always love seeing those bandits. God damn it, Mike!
I am so sorry.
Shit. Anyway, now we have a story of a young college dropout that went on to found a multi-million dollar company.
Yes, we bring it to you live from Palo Alto, California. Oh, that's kind of, sorry, I read it the wrong. Long Valley, New Jersey.
Yes.
Long Branch, New Jersey.
You know what? I'm going to try to do a real fucking twist.
Bro.
Yeah, you got it now.
I got it now, bro!
Yeah!
All right, let's go talk to some people. You got it, right?
Yeah, I got it. I got it down.
Bro.
What's up?
You got it.
I got it, yeah.
We're gonna talk to that guy. You got it, right?
Hell yeah. Watch this. What's up, bro?
Oh my, you are the coolest guy I've ever met.
Thank you. Good night.
Can you hear me?